Now, in the exam, they have asked you to calculate Q point for following circuit. The very first step is to observe the circuit. So, we will observe the circuit. While observing, we will come to know that certain points in the circuit. First, we will identify whether this is voltage divider bias or not. Now, as there are two resistors at the input side, R1 and R2, definitely it is voltage divider bias. Then there is a resistor at the collector and the emitter. So, it is definitely voltage divider bias, but there is a slight modification in the circuit diagram. You can see that now there is a battery, DC battery at the collector called as VCC is present. But along with that, another battery is present at the ground of minus 6 volt. So, this is a new variation in the voltage divider bias circuit. So, now in this particular case, before that, what steps you are following? First step is always redraw the circuit diagram. Second step is to get base current IB. Step 3 is to get collector current IC. And step 4 is to get VCE, collector to emitter voltage. These are 4 different steps in order to find out Q point. Am I right? Yes. But now, in the first step, in order to get VTH and RTH, equation of VTH will change. Let's see what is change in the equation. So, step 1, VTH is given as VCC multiplied by R2. Normally, the VTH is given as VCC multiplied by R2 divided by R1 plus R2 when this battery is absent. But whenever this battery is present, equation of VTH will become VCC plus VEE multiplied by R2 divided by R1 plus R2. And from whole term, minus or subtract the second battery. See, once again, the VTH will become VCC plus VEE multiplied by R2 divided by R1 plus R2. And from this whole term, subtract second battery. I'll write that this is R2 multiplied by VCC plus VEE divided by R1 plus R2 minus VEE. Let's see the equation. If we substitute the values, it is R2 is 23.5K, VCC is 6 and VEE is also 6. So, it will become 12 divided by 23.5 kilo plus 68 kilo minus 6. So, value is equal to minus 2.91 volts. Now, this is the value of VTH. RTH is given as R1 parallel R2, which is nothing but 68 kilo parallel with 23.5 kilo and value is equal to 17.46 kilo. This is the value of RTH. So, from step 1, we have got value of VTH and RTH. The next step is to redraw the circuit diagram and get value of base current and collector current and VCE. So, now step 2. The Thevenin's equivalent circuit will become as the VTH was minus 2.91 volts. So, it will be like this. This is VTH battery. Along with that, there will be a RTH. Now, there will be a transistor. Here, there will be the RE. Here, there will be the VCC and the RC. Value of RC is 2.5 kilo. Value of RE is 0.94 kilo. Value of RTH is 17.46 kilo. This value is nothing but minus 6 volt. Value of VTH is, now see here, the battery is positive to negative and hence I will write value of this is plus 0.91 volts. Value, while calculating, we have got minus 2.9. The voltage source cannot be minus. So, we need to change the polarity. So, we have changed the polarity. Between this point, there will be VBE. and here there will be VC. This current will be IB, this current will be beta plus 1 times of IB. Now, in step 2, we will try to find out base current IB, for which apply KVL to input. If we apply KVL to the input, we will get that this equation will become, the current is flowing from plus to minus, so it is minus VTH minus IB into RTH minus VBE minus beta plus 1 times of IB into RE minus, minus of minus will become plus VEE is equal to 0. Substitute the corresponding values, or before substitute the values, let's write base current on the left hand side and all voltages on the right hand side. So base current will become IB is equal to VEE minus VTH minus VBE divided by RTH plus beta plus 1 times of RE. This is very simple. What we have done is, we have taken all voltages on one side, whereas base equations on the other side, base current equation on the other side. In that particular case, the base equation become, the base current equation becomes VEE minus VTH plus VBE divided by RTH plus beta plus 1 times of RE. Now substitute the values, 6 volts minus 2.91 minus 0.6 divided by RTH is 17.46 kilo, beta is 180, so beta plus 1 becomes 181 multiplied by 0.94k. The value of base current is equal to 12.2 microamperes. Now, step 3, to find IC. We know that IC is equal to beta times of IB, and hence value of IC becomes 2.29 milliamperes. So we have got first Q point IC, or one parameter in the Q point called as IC. Step 4 is to find VCE. For that, apply KVL to output loop. Equation will become VCC minus VCE minus IC into RC minus IC into RE plus VEE is equal to 0. Hence VCE is equal to VCC plus VEE minus IC into bracket RC plus RE. Substitute the values, we will get VCE. VCC is 6 volts plus VV, repeat, VCC is 6 volts plus VEE is 6 volts. So it is 6 plus 6 minus IC is 2.29 milliamperes multiplied by RC is 2.5k plus RE is 0.94k. If we solve this, VCE is equal to 4.12 volt. Hence, Q point is 4.12, 2.29 milliamperes. This is how we can calculate Q point in voltage divider bias. Thank you.